Okay, and welcome to episode 64 of Going Native. Today I'm here with Brent and Kenny. Can you guys introduce yourselves quickly?
Hi, I'm Brent Rector.
My name is Kenny Kerr.
And what do you guys do here at Microsoft?
I'm a program manager on the Windows team. We're working on C++ WinRT right at the moment.
Yeah, I'm also on the Windows team. I'm an engineer. I work with Brent and a few others on C++ WinRT.
Great. Okay, so today's episode is about C++ WinRT. So can you guys give me a little bit of an overview of what that is?
Sure. C++ WinRT is a standard C++ based header-based library. So it takes WinRT APIs and exposes them as C++ classes that you can use in any managed or unmanaged application. Managed being, let's not talk managed for this thing.
Let's that's just a bad
talk,
word.
Yeah, yeah, talk unmanaged. Native apps.
Native, that's right.
C++ apps can use WinRT APIs in a natural and familiar way. Kenny may have more to add.
Yeah, that's a good summary. This is about standard C++, so we compile with Visual C++ as well as Clang. You can consume it from any standard C++ application, whether it's a console app, a desktop app, Win32 app, system service, whatever you like. This is the easiest way to get access to the modern Windows APIs.
And maybe we should take a moment and talk about a technology that it's like sort of replacing. Like, what is that the right way to think about it?
Yeah, sure, absolutely.
Yeah, it's kind of replacing C++ CX. We found that developers, in general, didn't like C++ CX as much as maybe we hoped at one time.
Yeah.
It has an unnatural syntax, it has hats, it does reference counting under the covers, you don't really know what's going on to some extent. And it's a proprietary Microsoft compiler, and people don't like being tied to one technology. And as Kenny mentioned, we work with Clang. We also work with Visual C++. We'll work with any standard C++ compiler as long as it's modern, let's say to the C++ 17 standard level.
Great. So this is sort of another one of those examples of kind of trying to hear the customer feedback and actually react to it here.
Absolutely.
Okay, cool. So why would I want to like access WinRT from my classic application or my UWP? Like, what would, for somebody who isn't already building against these WinRT applications, perhaps because they didn't want to take C++ CX into their dependence category, like what would be the major benefit of doing this?
Sure. Well, a lot of apps are, you know, come to Windows from the desktop. They come to Windows from other platforms. And they want to be able to light up. They want to be able to light up new features in Windows 10. And so they'll need some way of accessing those features. And the simplest way to do that is from standard C++. You have your existing code base that you've brought to Windows, and now it's on Windows 10, and you want to light up with the Surface Dial or perhaps the adaptive cards we're talking
about. It's a little twisty thing on the Surface Studio for the Surface Dial, if you haven't seen it.
Yeah, it's a very neat user experience. But you need to use the new Windows API for that. And so with standard C++, you can do so with C++ WinRT. There are other new features you want to light up, whether it's sharing or the adaptive cards. But all of those things are hard to get at if you're coming from a standard C++ code base and all of a sudden have to switch your compiler settings to switch to CX or create another process or another whole compilation unit just to get at those features. You want to just be able to hash include a header and start using those features. And that's what we enable.
Great. So tell me a little bit about what are some of the benefits of using, this is a better way to access the WinRT applications, but like what are some of the benefits over sort of the previous approaches?
Well, we found out to date, basically, we have a lot better performance and code size. Not only is it a header-based library, so you can see our entire implementation and you know exactly what we're doing, but the compilers, because we are heavily template-based and we're using modern constructs, can generate extremely efficient code for your applications as well. We have typically seen around a 30% code reduction when you go from a CX app, say using PPL for async work, to using C++ WinRT and in coroutines.
And that's generated code size or code source code?
That's binary code size. So.
Wow. Okay, so you can make it more small and therefore.
And we have a range of perf improvements as well. We believe, and correct me here if I'm wrong, that we're at worst equal to CX in performance for some special cases like calling static methods, functions like that. Or maybe 4.0 times faster.
Great. So anything else people should know about C++ CX before we jump into a demo that you guys want?
C++ WinRT, you mean?
C++ WinRT. Or anything you want bad you want to say about C++ CX would also be acceptable. But no, we
can there are enough people saying bad things. So we don't have to contribute. Yeah.
Okay, great. Let's transition to a demo.
All right. Well, the first demo I want to show you is just a straightforward console application and using some of the WinRT APIs. So just as an example, I have one here for you. So I'll go type app. And you can see here a simple console app. Here's your main function. We're using the Windows System Profile API to get the BIOS serial number from the machine. So this is a very low-level thing you might want to do. And again, this is not a UWP app. This is obviously a standard console app. And we can simply build it using CL. You can see I've chosen exception handling as well as C++ 17 support. And that's all it takes. I can then run the app, and I get my serial number. Again, no overhead here, no Apex, no packages. All of those things are gone. There's really no barrier to entry for this, to use this from a console app or a system service. Another example is a desktop application. So here, for example, I have a classic Win32 desktop application. You can see in the PCH, I'm including both modern WinRT APIs as well as some system headers. I have a helper header over here where you can see I've created a simple wrapper around an HWind and a window procedure. So you can see the window procedure that's managing the creation, so I can associate this pointer with the window. You can see I have a message handler where I handle some default messages. And then at the bottom here, I have some newer functions. The first one is a create dispatcher queue controller. And this is one of the things we need to try and fill the gap between what is no longer available in a typical store app. In a typical UWP, you'll have a core window as well as a dispatcher queue. Now, we don't have those on the desktop, and so what we need is to actually make that available to those applications. And we do that via the create dispatcher queue controller function. A second thing we need here is a way to create a rendered target for a desktop window. And again, here another helper that bridges that gap. But once you've done those things, it's fairly straightforward to take a typical desktop application. Here you can see I'm calling create window. I have a window class that I've established. I then have my message handler, and here I'm handling a button up event. So again, very standard Petzold style Win32 application. But if we go down a little bit further, you'll see that I'm actually creating the compositor. This is the Windows 10 composition engine. And I'm using that create desktop window target function to create a target to compose to. I then create a number of visuals, initially a sprite visual to act as the background for the window. And then I call this add visual function a number of times to create a number of visuals that we'll see on the screen in a minute. And here again, you see the same modern Windows API being used. I'm creating the visual with a certain brush, a size, and an offset. A little bit further down, you'll see there is your classic WinMain function. Once I've created the dispatcher queue, I create the window, I prepare those visuals we've just seen, and then we enter the message loop. So again, nothing out of the ordinary here. Any desktop application developer would recognize this immediately. So if we ran this application, and here you see the visuals that are initially created, and we can click around and you'll see a few more being created. And just to show that this is actually working for real, I'll add a breakpoint here to the message handler for the button up event. And we'll click again, and you see the breakpoint lands up there in your message handler. So again, a very standard, straightforward Win32 application, and you can naturally add calls to WinRT APIs using C++ WinRT simply by hash including the appropriate headers. I'd like to show you one more thing, and that is our XAML support. So let's close this down. And we've been working on a set of Visual Studio project templates to make it easier to get started with a new application. So let's just go File, New Project. And here you can see a few new project templates in the list here. One of them, I'll go up a little bit. So under Windows Desktop, you'll see a Windows console application. So again, just a standard console app, as you've seen a moment ago. But right inside of Visual Studio, under Windows Universal, you'll see three new project templates. There's a Windows Runtime Component for creating a DLL that exposes WinRT APIs. There's a core application if you wanted to build a direct 3D application, perhaps hosted in an iCore window inside of a store app. And then there's the blank app, which is your traditional XAML application. And I'll just use that one for now. And you can start to see the typical outline of a XAML application. You have your app.xaml as well as your main page.xaml. And over on the in the source code, you can see the main page itself. You can see we have an IDL page here, or IDL file here, where you see a constructor and a property called dummy. And you can change that to whatever you'd like it to be. But the projection also provides the member methods for you to override here and provide your own implementation. You can then run this application, and you'll see it, it should work just fine. Within a moment, it builds and runs. And there's the button. You can click on the button, and it does work just fine. We can even drop a breakpoint over here and see that in action. Let's try that again. And there, if we make a little bit of space, you can see we hit our breakpoint, and the application is up and running. So that just gives you a sense for what we're doing in terms of XAML support as well, and something you can expect in the future. But as you can see, you can use it from a variety of sources, a variety of different types of applications, and it works just fine.
Okay, thanks. All right, so that's the demo. So let's talk about calls to action. Where should people go to get started with this?
Well, the first place to go is to download the RS4 Windows SDK. It contains both all the headers, the C++ WinRT header files for all the Windows runtime APIs in RS4 and previous operating systems. It also has the C++ WinRT compiler in it, so you can generate your own language projections, your own headers for your own WinRT APIs. Additionally, if you're going to write XAML applications and you want decent project integration with VS, you'd go to the Visual Studio Extensions marketplace and download our VizX. It's not up there at the moment, the time we record this, but it will be at the time RS4 ships.
Got it. All right, so if you've got a UWP or even if you've got a classic MFC application that you want to light up for Windows 10, go ahead and check this out. Thank you very much.
Thank you.